Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day everyone. My name is Rahadian Aslam Siswanto. I am an MBA student of ITB in the class of Young Professional 65 Class C. Today I will be presenting about financial analysis of PT Jaya Real Property TBK in 2021. This presentation is a requirement for accounting final exam lectured by Dr. Erman A. Sumirat. Other than a lecturer, he is also a stock investor. For those whoever who wanted to learn more about stock investing, you could follow his Instagram at erman.sumirat. Now we're talking about the company profile of PT Jaya Real Property TBK. Established in 1979, PT Jaya Real Property TBK is now one of the country leading property developers with a diverse portfolio of residential and commercial developments in South, West, and Central Jakarta. The shareholders of PT Jaya Real Property TBK, 63% is by PT Pembangunan Jaya, and the others are public. This is the board of director and also vision and mission in PT Jaya Real Property TBK. You could see more in the website of jayarealproperty.com. Continue. This is the property residential portfolios. There are Bintaro Jaya, which I currently live in, Graha Raya, Serpong Jaya, Puri Jaya Pasar Kamis, Jaya Imperial Park, and then the condominiums are The Accents, Bintaro Plaza Breeze, Alexandria Silk Town, and Tower B Emerald. And then there is a retail property portfolios. There are Bintaro Exchange, Sleepy Plaza, Bintaro Plaza, Senen Block 4 and Senen Block 5. Now we are focusing on the financial statement. First is the asset. The total asset on December to June 2021 increased by 4%. This is due to a significant increase in current and non-current assets, which you can see in the right side. Now, the liabilities are actually also increased by 12% due to an increase in short-term liabilities that includes of business debt, other short-term financial liabilities, accrual expenses, employee benefits, sell advances, and also non-trade related parties. You could see more details in the right side. Now about the equity, total equities decreased by 0.1%. This is due to increase of treasury stocks and reduced non-controlling interest. And then, the cash and cash equivalents are actually increased by 21%. The cash earned from operating activities and inventive activities are the one who affecting the increase of cash. Now we're talking about profit and loss. The business profit decreased by 14% and the current year profit decreased by 8%. In addition, financial income from interest rates decreased by 30% and cost of goods sold and direct expenses increased by 9%. This increase is due to a significant increase in the cost of goods sold on condominium by 38%. Further explanations about profit and loss and other comprehensive income will be in the responsibility center. Now we are talking about financial statement by Mary Lynch. First, we calculate the working capital and current ratio. Based on the calculations, we can see that every 1 rupiah liability, there are 1.18 assets to become a reserve to pay its debts. It can be concluded that the working capital and current ratio of PT Jaya Real Property are in a good conditions. Now we're continuing to the current asset quick asset ratio. Every 1 rupiah liability, there are minus 4.71 quick assets to become a reserve, which means it can be concluded that quick asset ratio of PT Jaya Real Property cannot be relied on to pay its debt. Now we are looking at the debt to equity calculations. Based on the calculations, we can see that PT Jaya Real Property uses 0.52 liabilities for every 1 equity. It can be concluded that the amount of debt comparison with equities owned by PT Jaya Real Property is still relatively good. This is because the amount of equity is almost double of the amount of debt. Now, we look at the capitalization ratio. Based on the table, it can be seen that the percentage of liabilities to be paid using the largest of total capitalizations is in the advance from customer, with the percentage of 36% of the highlighted liabilities. So, it can be concluded that the ability of PT Jaya Property Tbk to pay its debt are quite well, and there are still remaining equities that have not yet been touched. Now, I will be explaining about the responsibility center. There are cost and revenue center, profit center, and ROE calculations. First, we're talking about revenue center. Most of the portfolios that generates revenue gained by PT Jaya Real Property Tbk is landlords, building units, condominium, and rentals. Based on the financial report on the second quarter in 2021, the total revenue suffered 3% losses. Revenue of property development by JRPT in the second quarter can be seen in the figure below. The declining of the revenue growth also affected greatly from other products beside the top 3 revenue generating product. This theory backed up by the previous financial report from 2017 until 2021 from the top 3 revenue generator units, which can be seen in the graphic in the monitor. From the figure, we can learn that the sales of building units and condominiums are actually increasing. But unfortunately, the landlord sales are significantly decreased. Other than that, the other product and services such as hotel, lease, ice rink, water park, and else are also declining. This affects the revenue even though they are not as high as those three products. This is the comparison for total revenue in the last 5 years. As you can see, in the 2019, it's actually decreasing until now. This due to the pandemic, which I will be explaining about it later. Now, we are focusing on the cost center. Same as the revenue center, most of portfolios that generate cost gained by PT Jaya Real Property is landlords, building units, condominiums, and rentals. Based on financial report on the second quarter in 2021, the total cost of revenue increased by 9%. Cost of revenue of property development by JRPT in the second quarter can be seen in the figure below. Well, based on the figure, we can see that the total cost of revenue is increasing by 9%. This increase generated by increase of cost of landlords, building units, and also condominium. Other than that, there are also an increase on estate management by 4% and rental by 9%. Ice rink and water park significantly decreased in cost. This due to the government to close the activities, so the costs are only for maintenance. Now we're looking at the cost center for the last 5 years, from 2017 until 2021. As you can see, the building units are mainly the cost generator here. So if PT Jaya Real Property wants to decrease its budget or more maximizing its cost, they should focus more on the building units first. Now we are talking about profit center. Based on what calculated in the revenues and cost center, also net income from financial report of PT Jaya Real Property Tbk that can be seen in quarter 2 of 2021, GPM and NPM can be calculated to see its margin. It's in the table 2. So based on the table 2, we can learn that after 2019, GPM and NPM of PT Jaya Real Property Tbk tends to be declining. These conditions occurs because of the declining of gross profit and net income. It's all connected in sales of product and services that JRPT provided. This mainly occurred because of pandemic in 2020 that affecting the sales unit. Now we are talking about profit center. In the table, we can see that landlords has the higher impact on profit, for around 40%, continued by building unit and condominium. Now, the last responsibility center is return on equity. The purpose of ROE calculations is to measure the ability of creating profit by the equity that given by the shareholders. Based on the figure, we can see that ROE of PT JRI Property Tbk in 2018 is actually increased by 0.3%. Unfortunately, in 2019, the ROE decreased around 2.2%. So, what we can conclude in the ROE? GRPT ability to generate profits based on the shareholders' equity is not in a good conditions. Even though the shareholders' equity increased in 19 until 2021, the revenue did not fulfill the expectations. The sales of GRPT's portfolio needs to be effective in order to bounce back. So what can I can conclude in this financial report? So GRPT is actually in relatively safe conditions, but it still needs improvement. These statements are supported from the ability of GRPT to pay its liabilities from total assets. Although they can't rely on quick assets, but the amount of shareholders' equity is almost double the amount of debt. Based on financial management, GRPT needs to improve on sales on top 3 profit generator units. Those 3 units are actually building unit by impacting 24% of its profit, condominium by 70%, and especially landlords by 40%. The most effective sales unit in 2021 is actually condominium. The other 2 units are not performing quite well. The cost revenue is increasing, but the revenue itself is decreasing. In order to bounce back, GRPT needs to find a strategy to sell their product or service that is available for sale for more effectively. In the financial report on June 2021, the availability of landlords dominating the inventories to sale. Since landlords is the most profit generating units, they have to focus on promoting and developing it. I recommend that GRPT should develop their landlords to targeting the creative industries such as coffee shops, co-working space, creative gallery, and creative compound. The trends are quite high in 2021, and I believe this strategy could increase the awareness of people in Jabodetabek area. I think that's all about my presentations. Thank you. Please don't forget to give a comment down below. Goodbye.